Hello and welcome to the Ditton Works YouTube channel. Today I'm going to talk about stands and I'm going to talk about vibration. Albert Einstein once said, all things in life are vibrations. And he's quite right, even down to an atomic level, electrons vibrating, it's pretty much the meaning of everything, vibration. And that's quite important to the likes of us who like vibration, because all vibration is in an atmosphere is sound. So what you have coming from your amplifier is an electrical signal, electrical energy, coming into the transducer, which converts that into kinetic or mechanical energy, which is pushing the air in front of the drive unit, creating sound waves. Now, it's reported that some speakers sound significantly better on what's called an open frame stand. A good example of that would be the EPOS, that people say, well, they don't sound any good unless they're on open frame stands. Now, another speaker that's quite famous for being on open frame stands is Harbeth. Now, Alan Shore of Harbeth has been quoted as saying, it doesn't matter what my speakers sit on, it could be a chair or a table, they're gonna sound good no matter what. But he doesn't sell stands, he sells speakers. And a manufacturer of stands for the Harbeth, something solid, are incredibly expensive stands. So they must think there's something in that. Now, for me, I've always wanted to try these, which are considered a lossy cabinet, compared to the Proax. Should be able to detect the difference in tone in those cabinets. These are quite a lossy cabinet. Now, I have tried these on what's more of a higher mass stand. So the Celestian stands on that my Proax is sitting on are lead filled, so their mass is high. They're very heavy and don't move at all. And as where these, they're reasonably heavy, but they're open frame. And I wanted to see if there was any difference in sound quality between a higher mass stand and an open frame stand. So let's have a look at that. So just quickly on the front of high mass stands, these are sonically dead. There's just no resonance coming through those at all. These are lead filled as well, and these target stands are incredibly heavy. Also, the A Compact cabinet is very rigid. It's not a lossy cabinet. But what we want to try and do with this particular setup is completely eliminate any vibrations, and all you're getting is 100% or near as 100% all the sound coming out of the drivers themselves and obviously the rear port. So that's the concept here, rigidity, high mass, low vibrations. With the open frame stands, it's almost the other way around. Although you've got a fine point of contact between the cabinet and the stand, the lossy cabinets are actually able to breathe a bit more, if you like, on the open frame stands. So I'm going to have a listen and then I'll report back. Okay, back to plonking a pair of speakers on, say, a chair or a table. If you played it loud enough, the vibrations from the drive units and the cabinets would actually transfer into the chair or the table. And if you played it loud enough for long enough, you'd probably find the speaker would move. The actual cabinet would start wandering around unless it was tacked into place. So what that says to me is there's an energy transfer from the cabinet into whatever's holding it in place, let's say the chair. Now, if it's able to move, that means there's a vibration being transferred, and vibration, as we've discussed, is sound. But in this case, that sound or energy transfer vibration into the chair is unwanted sound. That's what we call distortion. So I'm not sure I 100% agree that you can just plonk a pair of speakers down on a stand and they'll work. They'll obviously work, but are you getting the best out of them? So we've talked about spectral decay. We've talked about high mass stands. We've got two kind of concepts going on here. So with a very rigid speaker cabinet on a high mass stand, the kind of spectral decay or continuation of vibrations is very fast. If there's no additional ringing going on, you're not adding anything to the sound. It's diminishing the vibrations as quickly as possible. Now the Spendor concept is slightly different. This lossy cabinet goes back to a BBC idea of where the cabinet itself is adding something to the sound. And that's very carefully tuned. You couldn't just nail together a plywood box and it would sound fantastic. It would probably have awful vibrations that would be very audible. Now this finely tuned cabinet with its finely tuned driver, crossover, tweeter, sitting on these open frame stands gives the cabinet a little bit more breathing space. Even underneath, the bottom of the cabinet is allowed to breathe through this gap. So I'm going to have a listen and then we'll see if I think they've worked or not.
Ain't no sunshine when he's gone. It's not warm when he's away. Ain't no sunshine when he's gone. And he's always gone too long. Anytime he goes away.
Okay, how do they sound? In a word, they're a much, much more lively sounding speaker on these open frame stands. Everything's just got a little bit more richness to it, a little bit more warmth. These, which are not renowned for a big bass response, to be honest with you, sound a lot more bassy on these open frame stands. So in the situation where I've put a lossy cabinet on a high mass stand, I've reduced the bass response, strangely. So you would imagine that the bass would be more powerful on a high mass stand. Take it from me, the Pro Acs have way more bass if they're on a really rigid high mass stand. So do the A Compacts, so do the Celestian SL600s. But when I've run these on those stands, I always felt like they were missing just a little bit of low end. On these stands, the low end is there, it's solid, it's very, very pleasing to listen to. I think I might want to tune them a little bit more with experimenting with potentially little rubber feet just to lift them a little bit higher off the stands. I'm not a massive fan of putting spikes on the top of stands because that does damage the wood underneath, and I don't really like doing that at all. So I might try some of the Atacama isolation pads just to try and reduce a little bit of vibration traveling into the stand. But this theory of them being able to breathe more on the stand, in my opinion, certainly works. These sound way better on these stands than they do on those stands. And it's got nothing to do with height or anything like that. It's just purely the style of stand in which they're sitting on. So the people who have said things like the EPOS need to be on open frame stands, I don't know how lossy that cabinet is, but they're probably quite right. I haven't got a pair to try myself. Weirdly, I found a pair not so long ago, but they didn't have the right stand, so I didn't buy them. But in this situation, I'm really pleased that I found these stands, which weren't a lot of money. I found them on Facebook Marketplace for £30. This configuration here, very pleasing to listen to. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. It's kind of wandered around a little bit, but the end result was open frame stands on a lossy cabinet work. Open frame stands on a more rigid cabinet, I've not tried that yet, but I would imagine it doesn't work. High mass stands for a rigid cabinet, open frame lower mass stands for a lossy cabinet. Okay guys, that's the Ditton Works video for today. I hope you've enjoyed it. Take care and I'll speak to you soon.